What is up, guys? Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new to this channel, like and subscribe, hit a thumbs up, and say what's up. Today we start this video by going to get our haircut first with el primo Nando Fades. Shout out to Nando Fades. I got my son, el famoso Ruben, right here. Hi, Ruben. Start this video right now. Well, guys, today we're gonna go get our haircut, and we're gonna go back home and start packing up some merch. It's merchandise from the gym. We have a raffle here pretty soon. It's a $500 raffle. All it takes is you buy one shirt, you automatically enter. The raffle will be done December 18th. The last day to enter the raffle would be December 17th. So go to betruefitness.com and make your purchase today, because 500 bucks is 500 bucks, especially in this times of pandemic. We could all use a little extra money. So there you go, guys. Entonces aquí andamos con el Cuzzo on the page. Al famoso Ruben. Primo, where can people find you on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube?
Instagram, Nando Fades, or Nando H33, Nando H3, and then YouTube, Nando Fades.
Guys, I'll let you guys down in the link at the bottom, descriptions. I'll show you guys the description so that you can follow my cousin, and he has some badass haircuts he posts there. So make sure to follow him. Where's your playlist? Is your playlist?
I told my now that I'm like, hey, because she's like 16, I think. I'm like, what do kids listen to? Like what's a good playlist? Because I don't know what to play on Pandora, you know? Because I'm like, I think that I actually don't know what to play on Pandora. And so I have a playlist with Travis Scott, Nathaniel Cano, Drake, and you know? And I was like, well, I don't know if that's a good playlist, but.
What are you young whippersnappers?
That's exactly what I
listen to.
97.9, I don't have that.
I tell Felsie all the time, I go, hey, what's the new song? I'm still stuck to Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg. Los Canelos de Durango. I'm hate to say this, but I never thought I was gonna say that I'm old school. And I qualify as old school now. You know you are old school when you have this. Just for Men ain't cutting it no more. It is what it is, huh?
You gotta take it. Out of respect. The more kindness, the more they respect you.
Not like this guy right here. Hi, Ruben. Hey, I like that decal. That one, bam.
That one, it worked. Everybody asked me about it. But you had to take down your sign-off sign, huh?
Yeah. Huge shout out, guys, everyone that helped me again. Been saying this a million times, but if it wasn't for you guys, family, friends, I wouldn't have not won the city council seat. I'm gonna try again to do my hardest, make you guys proud. Everything you guys, you know, need or that we can bring into the city, we'll try our hardest. So yeah, let's see how that goes. Ahí está, guys. Good haircut. Igual de feo, pero de pelis el corte de pelo quedó chingón. Gracias a mi primo Nando Fates. The badass job. Hi, Ruben. What do you think, Ruben? Did very good job, huh? How many stars? 5 stars? I'd give him 5 stars.
Me too.
Do this. 5 stars.
5 stars.
5 star review. There you go. On the page. Ahora vamos a la casa. We're gonna pack some merchandise and get it ready to be sold. Entonces ahorita vamos a dar una vuelta a Wendover para que miren. Qué chulada. Todos que les gusta la mota, ahí está el lugar. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you are not yet following me, follow me. Saludos a las razas que no son de aquí, de Wendover, que están en California, Phoenix, Las Vegas. Un saludo para todos. Acuérdense su ranchito cuando vivían aquí. Ahí está la famosa 3 Miles. También saludos a la gente que nos mira desde México, Zacatecas, Jerez, Chipila. Está el golf, guys, para que se acuerden. Fue la raza que les tocó vivir aquí en este lindo ranchito. What's up, guys? So here we are packaging these shirts, B-True Fitness shirts. We have the Chicano series right here. And again, guys, to enter in the raffle, you go to btruefitness.com for a chance to possibly win $500 December 18th. Deadline is going to be December 17th. Every shirt you purchase, you automatically enter in the raffle to possibly win $500, guys. The reason I'm doing this in my channel, the Robert's Epic World, is because I feel like I have more followers or subscribers in this channel than I do in the B-True Fitness one. But anyways, follow B-True Fitness Instagram as well. Yeah, cool, for some cool content. Something funny, guys. So I've been saying the word content, and on the videos, it sounds like I'm saying cotton. So when I say follow me for more cotton, content, it sounds like con. So no, I'm not selling cotton. We're pushing the content, guys. So anyways, don't laugh when you guys hear me stop and really say the word content, because... So anyways, guys, while I'm doing this, I'd also like to take the time to thank everyone that supported me through the campaign. It is official. I won a city council seat for the West Wendover. Thank you very much, guys. Again, I couldn't have done this without you guys, and I will try my best to keep on moving in a positive direction, guys, because like I said before, city council people that were there before me did an awesome job. So I only want to say I will try to keep the positivity, keep on moving forward, keep on, you know, bringing better things to Wendover, West Wendover. So thank you guys very much again. I really appreciate the love and anything, any suggestion, guys, that you guys would like to see here in West Wendover, leave a comment below. Say, hey, we want to see this, we want to see that. Even though at the moment it might not be possible, you know, we're going through a pandemic here, but at least we can work on something, and you know, I can bring that forward to the city council. And you know, there's a lot of smart people out there that have a lot of great input in what we should have. So anyways, that's what's going on, guys. We have to save for rainy days because of this pandemic. We can't, you know, blow all our money right now. The governor just did a release 3 days ago. 3 days ago, I believe, mentioning that he's pleading that people please wear their masks. People please, anyone that doesn't have to go to work and or can work from home, to do so. He wants to see the numbers down, and so let's try to do that, guys. Wear a mask wherever we can. Man, the other day I got nailed by some folks because, you know, I have a business. The business is in the entertainment. However, I made a plan with the city and on how to, you know, try to run it as efficient and safe as I can. And so I've been executing that. And last year, we were able to hold 300 people for parties. This year, we can only do 150, with making sure that they're all wearing masks, keeping alive, et cetera, et cetera. So we've been doing a good job. With the release that the governor sent the other day, we will not be doing any more bigger parties, unfortunately, until we get the numbers down. So I'm playing a part, guys. I'm doing my, you know, trying to contribute to what the governor's saying. Guys, if we go on another 6 week shutdown, how it's coming out in the media. I don't know if you guys heard about it, but there's another statement that there's a possibility that we go close for another 6 weeks. That's separate from what the governor said, not to confuse. I seen on Yahoo News that they want a nationwide shutdown for 6 weeks, guys. That gives us enough time to think and reevaluate what we're doing as far as economically. Financially, guys, we should all be saving for rainy days. I feel that's what helped me keep the business above ground, was saving for rainy days. Times like this, that, you know, a lot of businesses went bankrupt. A lot of new businesses went bankrupt because they were just starting. So I feel for those businesses. I don't think there's nothing they could have done. There were some help for them. So I don't know how you can qualify or how you can't. I don't believe I could qualify just because I have another income coming in for my normal job. But prior to this, from the bouncy house days, we were already saving money, and because we put in hard work and a lot of sweat and hard work, I feel like, you know, that's where you you save money, you keep on progressing. For when stuff like this happens, you know, you're ready. Also, I'd like to touch base on that. You should be having a plan every year. You should be having a plan, you know, plan for a realistic, plan for 2 or 3 years from today. Say, this is where I want to be. This is where I see myself. And nothing's ever going to come easy. There's going to be for those of you guys like myself that didn't go to college, you guys will be tripping on things that are gonna be coming your way. When I started the bouncy house business, you know, I if I want to work in the bigger areas, schools, parks, etc., I found out I had to have have insurance. I had to have a few other things that go along with having that bouncy houses, and it's just to protect yourself. But that insurance comes at a higher price because it's a huge liability. You know, you save money, and then later on, it's like, man, how do I do a business where I can work smarter, not harder, you know? And the bouncy house deal went very well. It was a side hustle, great money maker. The reason I got rid of it was because at the moment, I didn't have enough help. And that's a lot of, you know, labor intensive. Those who helped me, my brother-in-laws, my friends, my family, you know, huge shout out to them. They know what I'm talking about. Nothing came easy for me, guys. It was a business that involved a lot of hard sweat. And but again, this all comes back to saving money. And my thought process was work smarter, not harder. Then this gym opportunity came, and I'm like, all right, let's try it. You know, I've always tried to work out, guys. It might not show. Unfortunately, I'm not 100% dedicated where I'd like to be, but that's because, you know, I'm always involved in other, you know, I have my regular job and I have other little things I have to worry about, but my family, most important. But, you know, I still try to make time to work out. No excuse not to work out at least 40 minutes a day, man. So anyways, that was my next goal, was the gym. Let's try this gym thing. I got to the gym, and prior to where I owned it, and I always try to see how can you better that business. And where I thought I could better that business was in, you know, obviously bringing a little bit more weights in, more machines, and also getting a program to help me monitor, you know, how many people come through. Make it easier for my customers, my clients, my members, to where they can just pay online and just have their key fob ready to work. So if you want to take a month or two off, awesome, but then you're ready to jump back in, just make that payment online and you're back in business. So anyways, that's what I thought in the business. And anyways, so moral of the story, guys, is save money, because you never know when opportunity is going to come. And if you're just blowing it on things that aren't making you money, you're going to find out that when you are ready to make a commitment, a jump, you're scrambling for, you know, running to your parents, running to whoever to get that money, because the opportunity is there, but you can't capitalize. It's happened to me already, guys. You know, even as I'm talking to you right now, you get too comfortable, you get too happy, you buy things that you shouldn't be buying at the moment, and then when an opportunity comes, you know that you can handle it, but you just don't have the capital, and then the bank wants to see that you have money in certain amount of money for the project that you're trying to do in the bank, or else they're not going to loan you the money. That simple, guys. So save money, save as much as you can, because better times are coming, guys. And if you're not prepared right now, you guys are going to miss out on a lot of cool things like real estate. You know, people are going to find themselves right now that they bought expensive stuff and, you know, they can't afford it. So a lot of high-priced items are going to be discounted at a cheaper price. Homes are going to be sold cheaper. You know, I'm not a market analyst, but that's sort of what I've seen from my short time living in this beautiful planet that's called Earth. You always have to be ready. You always have to have a little bit of capital, guys. Nothing comes easy. you know, I still have a long ways to go, but it's funny that I've been criticized and called lucky for having what I have, and it's not luck, guys. It's honestly, it's hard work, and it's timing. Timing is everything as well. And when the timing comes in right, you have to have a little capital to jump, anyways, that's how we've done it, guys. With the help of everyone, I feel like I have great relationship with a lot of great people. I always wish positive vibes to everyone, even though when I'm, you know, when I've been told that I take advantage of people, or I do this or I do that. And realistically, guys, I don't take advantage of no one. Those who know me know my work ethic. Those who don't know me would like to think that I got lucky, that I'm at where I'm at, just because, you know, I was a kid that was born. Those who know where the Red Garter Trailer Court's at know what I'm talking about. Those that were my friends when I was a kid know what I'm talking about. To those guys, shout out, man. Those were my best moments in my life, guys. I didn't have cell phones. I didn't have social media. All we had was bicycles and a football, guys. And we pretty much closed the roads to play football. You know, you guys that were with me when I was small, you guys know what I'm talking about. Best times of my life was at the Red Garter Trailer Club, man. That's where I was raised. And again, guys, I had two choices. I could either, stay there, or I could progress. And I want to progress. And if whenever you want to do something, guys, you'll find out that it can be done, man. You can break the cycle. My parents, they're humble people. Their plans were different than my plans. Their plans were saving money and go to Mexico. I'm fortunate to have my parents, and my wife is fortunate to have her parents here. And we don't have to go to Mexico as much as they did when they were here, you know? So, you know, we visit Mexico as much as we can, try to go every year, but we don't have to make that extra expense they did to buy a house over there. And we, you know, our mentality is to stay here. We'll go to Mexico whenever things are calmer or safer. That's another thing, guys. I don't fall into the hype there's bad things happening in Mexico. There's bad things happening here, you know, where we live. You don't have to go to all of Mexico to get a bad experience. Tragedy happens everywhere, man. So, anyways, guys, it was fun. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, like, subscribe. I'm gonna put down a few links of where we went today. And anyways, we'll see you at the next one.